Arabic learning must be easy. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Luay. Welcome to the third lecture of the language course on our channel Academia Dimashq or Damas Academy. Here we go. What shall we do today? So in this video we got to know the following. Step number one is the introduction, where I will provide some interesting cultural information regarding the language, just like I do in every lesson in our course. Then in the second step we learn the third letter. In the third step we will practice tashkilat as usual. And the last part of our talk today is grammar. We got to know new tashkilat regarding the articles that we already learned in the second lesson. More than 467 million can speak Arabic, and Arabic is the fourth most widely spoken language in the world. Many scientific and cultural references were written in Arabic, for example, medicine, history, engineering, mathematics, etc. And in 2013, the UK Council published an in-depth report on the most requested languages in the UK under the title The Languages of the Future, and found Arabic to be second in the world and fourth in 2017. Our letter today is Ta. The Ta is written in such a way that it looks like a duck with the addition of two dots or a line on top. There is also the explanatory video that clearly shows how to write the Ta. So, as we learned the letter Ba in the last video, the letters have different forms. The letter Ta also has three forms, namely as it's written at the beginning of the word, or in the middle, or at the end of the word. But there is an exception for the second and third form, as in the last lecture. It may be that the letters are generally in the middle or end of the word and still don't have the original form. We will see this in the following examples. And now the video. The first form, the second form, and the third. Let's go on. Here we have two examples of the first form of the letter Ta at the beginning of the word. As simple examples, we have the noun Tut, so Dhamma on Ta, and Sukun at the end. Tut means berries. And the second example, the noun Teen, there is Kasra under Ta and means figs. In the first example, Tut, Ta takes the first form at the beginning, and that is regular, but the next Ta, where it's actually at the end of the word and at the same time has the main form or the original form. Exactly as already clarified, the reason behind this time is the letter Waw. There is the rule that says there are certain letters that are only partially connected to the other letters in the word, such as the letter Waw in this example. We see that Waw is only connected to the previous letter but not to the next, so partly. In this case, write the next letter with the original form if there are no additional letters in the word. On the next slide, We also have two examples of the second form of the letter ta, namely kitab, kitab. This means book, and al-kitaba, al-kitaba means the writing. Both words have the same root, as you can clearly see. Next, we have two examples of the third form of ta. We have here the noun bint, which means girl or miss. You notice that there is kasra under ba, sukun on the letter noon, which we will get to know later, and then sukun on ta. The second example uses the word zayt, so fatha on zay, sukun on ya, and sukun on ta. Zayt means oil. That was all about the third letter ta, and finally we come to the grammatical part. Today we will take a look at what's new in tashkilat regarding the articles. In our first lecture, with this slide, we got to know tashkilat. Fatha for short a, or a actually, dhamma short u, kasra short I, and sukun for silence. Today we are concerned with what kind of change regarding tashkilat only at the end of the noun if the article is definite or indefinite. If the case is definite, so there is al at-ta'rif in front of the noun, then there are only four possibilities for the melody of the noun end. That depends on what case the word has in the sentence. We will learn something like that soon after a few necessary preparations to pave the way. So the end of nouns with a definite article can be either fatha, dhamma, kasra or sukun if the case is indefinite. So there is no al-at-ta'rif in front of the noun. Then there are three new options as alternatives to the previous ones. If the last letter of the noun has fatha on it, then it's converted into tanween al-fath, drawn as a double line so that the last letter is no longer pronounced with a melody but is pronounced with an. Now when the last letter of the noun has dhamma on it, it's converted into tanween ad-dham, drawn as a double dhamma so that the last letter is no longer pronounced with U melody but is pronounced with on. In the third case, the same. If the last letter of the noun has kasra below, then it's converted into tanween al-kasr, drawn as a double line under the letter so that the last letter is no longer pronounced with I melody but is pronounced with N. In the case of sukun, it always stays the same. Let's take a few examples of tashkilat with a definite or indefinite article. In the first example, az-zayta, az-zayta, fatha is on ta. Without al-at-ta'rif, fatha is converted to tanween al-fath at the end of the noun and pronounced zaytan. In the second example, al-bintu, dhamma is on ta, al-bintu. Without al-at-ta'rif, dhamma is converted to tanween ad-dham at the end of the noun and pronounced bintun. In the last example, az-zayti, kasra is under ta, az-zayti. Without al-at-ta'rif, kasra is converted to tanween al-kasr at the end of the noun and pronounced Zaytin. That was all for this lecture. To practice writing the letter, I have attached a PDF file in the info box below. You can print it out and then take your time to practice writing with it. I have also prepared a small quiz for you. And finally, in the third document, I summarized the content of the video for you. I hope that the lesson was simple and understandable for you. So good luck and see you next time.